have a weakness on two secondaries, you can negate the weakness.
If you have,
you have a weakness caused by two secondaries with the same dysfunction, you deal negative weakness. Then, because the problem comes from the weakness, from the secondaries, virtues, you deal negative weakness and function. Unless you test only the primary and secondary, in your caso. But because it's the very end of the chain, normally it's not happening. Let's see if he is going to be the second man with hormones weak in the clinic. Sometimes if I test the latissimus dorsi, as an example, right, test strong. Yes? The problem is we don't use the forearm to move things, we use the hand. When we test the muscle, we test the, only the muscles. Or maybe a couple muscles more or stabilize. But we need the hand. We need the thorax. We need the other part of the body to do activities during the day. If I test now, but now I'm going to hold the small finger, hold, it's still strong. Hold the ring finger, it's strong. Hold now the middle finger. Yes. The small one, the finger, is still strong. It's not a problem. But if I test and grab the middle finger in this case, this is lazy. But then we need to start to think in kinematic chains. Sometimes some muscles want to test weak if it's hypermoving, but sometimes they are going to test strong because it's basic mode or multimode. And as soon as you increase the distance or increase or you add secondaries to the kinematic chain, now test weak.
In that case, you can set the dorsal is weak.
Yes and no. The muscle is strong in the clitoris. But if I grab the middle finger, I'm going to put a stress on the kinematic chain. The kinematic chain is dysfunctional, and now there's weak all the chain.
And you need to see where is the dysfunction.
Here's the third step. First step is to test. Is weak in the clitoris? Yes, it's now UTL strong, no. Oh, it's strong in the clear, but you can see that the patient complains or the patient cannot do a special task, or they change the position to do the task. Now, we can think that maybe we have a kinematic chain. Yes.
If it is PDTR when you push the...
I just grab this one. Ah, yes, of course. If I test here, the middle finger, and this is weak, UTL, now it's strong. Yeah. I can confirm that this is human chain. Okay. The most common diagnosis is visual. For example, I want to move a table, for example, the table. I can hold it. But for any reason, hold it. And the patient move the hand and can grab here. He like here. Why he cannot do that here and put that here? Because here, now he's using a different kinematic chain. Sometimes, you can see in the gym, the patient grab the barbell. No, I like beer.
White grip.
This is whatever you need a big barbell. White grip. Or I'm going to do the barbells. And instead of do the barbells here, I do the barbells here. But I don't like here. I like here. Why you cannot do it here? Why you need to do here? Or the patient loves to do squats, but he need to rotate the legs. Because we have a big muscle there. Can be or not kinematic chain, but this tells us that he is trying to use some muscles. Then we need to test the muscles, find the big muscle, UTL, strong is kinematic chain. Got it? There are many conditions. For example, patient have a deltoid. Strongly clear. This is strongly clear. Yes? And now, quick. Straight. Immediately, that will be inside. Stronger muscles. I put in the straight position, now it's weak. And then immediately try to compare it with the jaw. Then we need to see all these details. Because if not, we are not going to find weak muscle. We want to miss some weak muscle. Everybody has some weak muscles. Nobody has a perfect body. But but we need to see how the patient compensates how he does to do the task. How nice is this position?
No, if you fast a year longer, of course not.
Longer could be 3 minutes.
Five.
Why? Because in this position, he has to use all the kinematic chain that is weak. What's wrong? You see the arms, merely? Then we are going to working. And this is weak. Got it? As soon as they try to test, immediately he tried to compensate. Open the legs. Put the hand there. this is strong. Left, and this is really weak. Then heart. What many people said that most of the heat is not reliable. Is reliable. We are not reliable. Muscle testing is amazing, but the problem is that many times we don't know how to test because nobody teach how to test. The classical testing is just to test the specific muscles in a specific position, the classical test, but we are going to have a lot of hidden weaknesses because we don't know how to find them, or we don't know how to, we don't see how the pain is compensated. These are very clear. No, no. Oh. Okay. Oh. This is strong. This is really weak. Yes? If I withdraw, I avoid him to use other chains, and I avoid his compensation, he cannot do it. Now, again.
Can you give me the time?
Can I do it? Of course. Can I wait? You did? Now, he's strong. These are hidden chains. Is it clear? Okay. My next question is, I need to find the primary and main secondary. Because, I don't know which would say the primary, maybe I need to trace all the chain and try to find if it is the size of primary or not. With double steam helps, but it still takes a lot of time. Then I'm going to use an indicator muscle with the chain. This is weak. Okay. If I rub the chain to the primary, to the center of the primary, an indicator muscle becomes weak. If I rub to the wire to the secondary, keep it strong. Now I know that the primary is here.
So
simple. Rule the chain. Yeah, the chain come from here to here, and then to the leg problem. If I rule in the along the chain toward the side of the primary, now becomes weak and indicator muscle.
Okay, and then you first you make like that, and then you make like that. It's the same.
No. So the primary is weak, so the secondary is strong. Indicator muscle. Okay, look at this again. Here is the primary. If I root to the side of the primary, it will get the weaker. If I root to the opposite side, it will get the keep strong.
Se for na direção do secundário, fica forte. Se for no primário, fica fraco.
Ok, ok.
Não, sabes que o primário está numa ponta. You know that the primary is...
It's somewhere here. It's somewhere here.
It's somewhere here.
Okay. It's somewhere here. In this side. Why? 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 Because it's a rule. It's a rule. If you rub the kinematic chain to one side, to the side of the primary, indicator will become weak. It's a rule. It's like a...
No, se faz em direção do secundário, fica fraco. Se faz em direção do primário... Desculpa, se faz em direção do primário, fica fraco. Se faz em direção do secundário, fica fraco.
Sim, mas o secundário até podia estar aqui.
Não podia. Se tu fizesse assim, e eu ficasse fraco.
Forte.
Fraco. É forte.
Forte.
Exato.
Pois é. Espero for you to say it again.
Yeah. Okay. This is the primary. If I loop in this direction, indicator muscle weakens. It's hard to understand. Okay. Second rule. If I loop the kinematic chain primary, the weak kinematic chain strains. Same direction. I loop to the primary, indicator weakens, and kinematic chain, if this is weak, becomes strong. If this is strong, weakens. First rule, loop to the primary, indicator must become weak. Second rule, if the kinematic chain is weak in the clear, loop to the primary and become strong. If this is strong, become weak. Means flips. Then, in this case, anti-stim. Because rubbing in any direction has the same results. Mm-hmm. If this is a rubbing, it's a mechanoreceptor here, and it's not in a chain, it's just a mechanoreceptor, rubbing in this direction, will decrease the signal of the mechanoreceptor, and it will be better, the associated muscle.
Still that UTL to confirm if it's a kinematic chain.
And if it's not kinematic chain, UTL will not happen. Then we know that this is not rubbing because we need to see how it works. We may have three problems. Rubbing. One is rubbing to know it's kinematic chain. Second, could be rubbing and this steam of mechanoreceptor. Third, can be a steam of the crude touch. Yeah? How can I know if which one is the problem? If I rub with UTL and become weak, it's crude touch. If I rub in any direction and it helps, it means it's the anti-steam of the receptor, mechanoreceptor. If I look in this direction only, and helps, help the weak chain, this is weak, or inhibit the chain, this is strong, and inhibit the indicator muscle, but not in any other direction, then this is a rubbing for the chain. And if you rub against the hair, and we UTL inhibits, but not in other direction, maybe it's a spin of hypothalamic. We want to see that the last day.
And meridian. Yeah.
Or carry meridian. Meridians, if you root the meridian against the meridian, the muscle, the meridian muscle becomes weak, not the chain. meridian muscles. You rub the meridian in the same way of the meridian, if they are weak muscles, the weak muscles, or the meridian, they're going to be stronger. But it's only the specific muscle of the meridian. We're going to see that that module. Then rubbing has 5 or 6 different options. But we have the tools enough to know exactly what kind of stimulus we are doing. Got it? Okay, I think that is needed another explanation. Do you understand it clearly? Yes. It's clear for you?
Si.
It's clear? Okay. In
Portuguese.
French.
No, it's not Portuguese.
French. Come on.
Please translate to
Polish.
English.
Polish.
German.
German.
English.
Chinese.
German.
No, because he wants to be in Portuguese to English.
Okay, English.
Então, a ideia aqui é nós conseguirmos observar e avaliarmos e vermos como é que o paciente se comporta quando nós estamos a gestar. Temos que perceber, no fundo, qual a posição, o que é que ele visita para nos dar pistas. Bem, o que José disse é que quando nós fazemos um teste, okay, e quando nós testamos um músculo e o músculo está fraco, okay, está inibido, okay, uma das maneiras que nós temos para saber se é ou não uma long kinematic chain é fazermos um UTL.
Okay?
Portanto, quando nós fazemos um UTL, o UTL vai negar a fraqueza da cadeia. Ok? Pronto. Segundo ponto, e que o José aqui explicou, é podemos ter joint capsule or non-joint capsule. Ok?
Polish, no, this is English. Portuguese.
And then there's a Golgi in the capsule. Golgi in the capsule or um Golgi fora da capsule. Portanto, neste caso, no caso do Henrique aqui, como o José demonstrou, quando nós encontramos um músculo inibido, okay, portanto, imaginemos que está inibido, okay, portanto, se nós fizermos na direção do primário, okay, se estiver
inibido... Ok, em inglês, em português.
Se estiver inibido, vai flip, ou vai trocar, neste caso, e irá fortalecer a cadeia. Ok? Quando estamos com um músculo indicador, ok? Portanto, fazer um rub em direção ao primário, ok? Vai inibir o nosso músculo indicador, ok? E este aqui é sempre. A diferença é quando nós temos uma cadeia ou músculo relacionado estiver fraco, portanto, fazer na direção do primário vai fortalecer a cadeia. Se estiver forte, fazer na direção do primário vai inibir a cadeia. E no indicador é sempre inibição. Okay? Lembrem-se, okay? Nós estamos sempre a estimular os secundários. Na direção do primário, inibe o músculo indicador. Sempre. Okay? Sempre. Músculo indicador, músculos relacionados. São assuntos diferentes. Músculo relacionado encontra-se dentro da cadeia. Rub na direção do primário, se estiver fraco, é o flip. Se estiver fraco, fica forte. Se estiver forte, vai ficar fraco.
Sempre fraco.
Ok? Pronto.
Indicador, quando tu fazes um rub, independentemente da direção do
primário. Se for na direção do primário, ok? E se for uma kinematic chain, tu tens que confirmar primeiro com o UTL, ok? Portanto, à partida encontras um músculo fraco, UTL, fortalece-te, ok? Será uma kinematic chain, ok? Portanto, a partir daí, olhamos para a pessoa, verificamos o que a postura, o que é que a pessoa evita, tal como o Henrique fez, assim que o José pediu para ele se endireitar, o Henrique abriu, tornou logo a cadeia de modo a fortalecê-la, ok? Pronto, nós temos que estar atentos a essas situações, atenção às compensações, voltar para a posição.
Mas quando eu testou o músculo associado, já estava fraco e depois já ficou forte com o TEL. Portanto, ele não se adaptou a nada.
Não, quando ele pediu para ele se endireitar, ok? Ficou fraca a cadeira. Não, no primeiro, quando ele testou a primeira vez o deltóide, o posterior, se não me engano. Quando ele testou a primeira vez, estava fraco, porque ele estava numa posição confortável e não estava a utilizar a cadeira. A partir do momento em que o José pediu para ele se endireitar, okay, ele foi testar a cadeira e, neste preciso momento, assim que ele endireitou, ele logo abriu, okay, afastou a perna e afastou o braço. Okay, para quê? Para usar outra cadeira para lhe dar mais suporte e estabilidade.
Ele quando sentou aí, quando usou o músculo associado, estava forte.
Porque ele estava a usar outra cadeira.
Depois, endireitado e ficou fraco.
Ficou fraco. Enquanto
e aí o TEL, fez o TEL e ficou forte.
E ficou forte.
Porque é cadeira? Quando é que
a cadeira fica forte? Qual é a cadeira que está fraca?
Sabes que aquela cadeira que eu mostrei em mim. Pronto. Depois, muito simples. Rápido na direção do primário, ok? Se a cadeira estiver fraca, flipa. Okay? Se estiver fraco, flipa também, fica fraco. Okay? Músculo indicador, rub na direção do primário, fica sempre fraco.
Mas agora digo uma coisa. Primário parte do princípio que é flexilado.
Não sabes.
Tu sabes
é se
tens que ver os comportamentos da cadeia,
se fizeres isto
e começas a testar.
O primário pode ser na perna contrária, não é?
Não, porque se fizeres na direção da perna contrária, ele basicamente vai ficar forte, não fica fraco.
Não faz nada,
This
is hypermobility, it is hypermobility or not? Because this is weak. It's hypermobility. Yes. But when I do that, I'm stressing the chain.
Yes.
Maybe it's strong in the clear, and now we can, as soon as I stress it. But well, it is just weak in the clear. This is weak in the clear. And I tap one time, becoming strong. What? What? Because I see one secondary.
Improve the primary,
improve the rest of the zones. And this one is weak here, but it's not enough to hit the chain. Yes? But if I test or stretch or hit or stretch both, now indicator could be two secondaries in here and indicator one. And you deal. Now keep it strong because you deal and get the women. Yes? Clear? Okay. The problem, the rules are easy. Now, if I root to the primary, this is weak, become strong, this is strong, become weak. If I root to the primary, indicator was a little weak. It's clear, it's so simple. The problem is, how can I see the dysfunction? In this case, if I test him, this is strong. Or I put him this one, and this is strong. The brain is so smart. The goal of the brain is to be strong. glucose. In this case, we can know that this kidney chain when the patient needs to rotate or to change the position to be strong. It means he needs to use another kinematic chain. Because opening the legs helps. Probably the chain go to the arm and go to the legs, probably the right side. Jaw, in this case, could empower the jaw, part of the kidney chain, but in this case, it's a compensator. It's just a compensator. In this case, you may test the patient. When you are going to test the kidney chain, this is strong.
This is weak.
Then he needs to open the leg to make it strong. Probably he needs to reduce the stress of the, this part of the kidney chain to make it stronger. See that again? When I test a patient, I need to see how the behavior of the patient. If he has already the legs open, it's going to be hard to find him. If he has the legs closer, and when I'm going to test, he opened the legs, it's going to be easier to see them and change. Open the leg. Okay, this is strong. In this position, it's strong. If I move here, this will be to me. Now, it's strong. A little bit of the thorax. Now we can again. No, it's too strong. Take it to the side. Okay, now we begin again. Got it? In this position, I am stretching again the chain. Then, in the opposite side, the lateral side of the chain, I can test this one, rub lateral side. For the primary, this is me. Yeah. Can you see? It's the same chain. If I
was the primary, it wasn't
either.
And
go from here there.
The cruzada atrás.
Hold there.
Please.
If I move in this direction, in direction. Okay. Now the chain open the lateral side and go to the front of the knee. Before, I had to make test two secondaries. Now, with this rule, it's faster to find them.
Victor.
Yeah. Give me the this one. What's up? Okay. The chain is in the middle finger, same as the latissimus dorsi. In this case, double stem, weakens. The end of the chain is in the distal interphalangeal joint. Now, double stem, weakens, double stem, here in the foot is the main secondary. He believes he fixes it. But it's no priority. He has a good touch in the face that is the secondary to the one. Normally, kinematic chain are about 35 to 40% priorities, and 60% are non-priorities. 20% of pressure, 15% of pressure, more or less. Maybe 40, 45. Then, now, we need to treat them with steam the primary, steam secondary, DTR, that's it. But we need to check later, as soon as we learn how to treat the priorities, we are going to pick the priority first.
Podemos tener más de una cadena.
Can we have more than one chain?
We need to have an idea of the chain, we need to see. Again, as soon as we test the patient, this is weak, ask him to push harder, and you will see how the patient moves, tries to compensate. The compensation in the chains, we have two kinds of compression. Decrease the stress over the chain, or rotate if it is not possible. Example, he is a this is weak. But how can, what is the best option for his brain? Rotate the arm a little bit. Now, this is strong. Now, this is strong because he's testing this chain, not this chain. If he put the hand there, this is strong. There, this is strong. But that's why it is exactly the chain.
Yes, but before that, of doing all that movements to try to catch the right kinematic chain, you do UTL to search if it's
chain or not. This is okay, this is weak.
If not, it's useless.
No. Yeah. No, in this case, you are going to do the rotation, not me. I test the patient, and you will see that he will rotate the arm. Why he rotate the arm? Because he doesn't want to test the weak chain. Then I'm going to move back to put in the proper position. This is weak, and now you need to ask the patient to do the WUTL. The UTL makes it strong, and now you configure the chain. Got it?
Oh, yeah.
You're never.